You've learned a little bit about infrastructure as code. In this episode of Data Exposed, we'll dive a little bit deeper into how you can use it with AKS and SQL Server. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed MVP Edition. This week, we have back Hamish Watson. Thanks for joining us again.
Thank you. It's great to be part of this. Yeah.
And in the last episode, we talked about infrastructure as code and how you can use it to do things like deploy Azure SQL Database. But in this episode, we're going to see how you can use it for other things related to SQL. Why don't you go ahead and kick it off and tell us what else we can use it for?
Awesome. Thank you, Anna. Well, yeah, today I'm going to show people how we can spin up a Kubernetes cluster. And we're going to use Azure Kubernetes services. Why don't I jump in and I'll show you. Alrighty. So here we have my Windows machine. It's just a VM. And on here, I have Visual Studio Code. And today, what I'm going to be doing is deploying out an Azure Kubernetes services cluster. This is where infrastructure as code is really awesome, because it means that I can create a standardized resource. I can feed in what I want to put in there, different namespace, whatever, and deploy this out and then start using it. So what we'll do is do exactly that. So I'm just using Bash. And this is going to go out and deploy my resources into Azure. And so this will take a wee while to do, but what we'll do is we'll come back when it's deployed and then we'll start actually using it.
Okay, cool. So it seems like this has finished and it looks like it was pretty simple. You just ran one kind of command, one kind of file, but what really happened underneath there and what did it do?
Yeah, absolutely. And this is not a smoke and mirrors demo. So basically, I've got a whole heap of commands in my file. And look, to be honest, they're not the hardest ones in the world to learn. Basically, what we're doing is we're using YAML files. And so this file here is for our persistent storage, because we want to persist storage against our cluster, which is where we're going to store our databases. And we then have a deployment YAML file, which is where we're actually going to deploy SQL Server in a container on our Kubernetes cluster. So it's really just bringing all these commands into one place so that we can, you know, again, we could have this file in source control. We could fold it into our CI/CD pipelines, you know, in Azure DevOps, doing our releases. We pull this out, build our cluster, deploy our containers, do our stuff. And then you know what? We might just delete the containers and get rid of the whole cluster. Just depends on whatever we want to do. So what I'll do now is we'll actually connect to the cluster. We'll have a look at SQL Server databases that we're going to put in there, and you'll notice that, you know, as we go along, a lot of this feels very familiar. So I'm going to jump into Azure Data Studio. I'm going to connect to my cluster address, and again, this has been provisioned using infrastructure as code. In this particular case, I was using the Azure CLI, and what I did do was I created a secret for the SA password so that I don't have to give that password out. You know, I don't have it in scripts and what have you. We can actually use it as a secret. So what we have here is basically SQL Server. It's running on the Kubernetes cluster. I'll just quickly grab my file, because what we're going to do is actually run a script to create my database. So let's do that. And this is going to go away. It's going to create a database. And what I'm doing is I'm installing tsqlt, which is a testing framework for SQL Server. And what it means is that we now have the ability to run unit tests against a database written in tsql. And this is actually the first time I've decided to run it in Azure Data Studio. Normally, I would run it in SQL Server Management Studio, but the really cool thing is it works here as well. And so, you know, we have a very simple database. We've got our tsqlt framework. By the way, tsqlt is free, so that's kind of a really nice aspect of it. And what we can now do is just do a really simple run of our tests. And so I've written some unit tests in this database, which I've just deployed. And you'll notice here that, thankfully, my unit test passed. But this really opens up the doors for us, because now we can build a Kubernetes cluster using Azure Kubernetes Services, because it's an important thing. I have built Kubernetes clusters on physical VMs and on, physical hardware as well as VMs. And it's a learning curve. It's definitely not a one-line script. And when the Azure platform came out with Azure Kubernetes Services, or AKS, I immediately jumped on, because it manages all the horrible things that I have had to do, the installation, the upgrade, the management. And now being able to run SQL Server in a container on it is just a game changer for me. It's changed how I use the platform, and more importantly, how I provision that platform for other people in a DevOps, in CI/CD. So I'm hoping that, you know, again, this is another thing that, you know, shows you, the audience, some really cool things that you can do up in Azure.
Thanks, Hamish. It was really interesting to see, you know, how you basically built this very repeatable set of scripts that you can use to either deploy AKS and then deploy SQL Server into it, as well as that whole automated script that you use to install tsqlt and run some unit tests. So that's really interesting. You know, I wanted to flip it back to you and say, like, you know, we've had these two videos about infrastructure as code. What do you think the most important takeaway for a viewer is, and what should they go do first?
Cool. Thanks, Anna. Look, I think that people need to just jump on board, just to go out and just try things on the Azure portal, right? The Azure platform, and start small. There are a whole heap of people that are blogging, myself included, on how to create resources up there, how to use Azure Cloud Shell, how to use Azure CLI. And look, just start small, try a few things. Because the thing is, I think of Azure like this. Do I have a massive team of security people looking after my databases? No, I don't. But there's a whole heap of teams at Microsoft that are looking after the Azure platform. You know, there is a whole heap of things that are default in Azure that people just don't do. And one of the things I'm really, really passionate about is not only, you know, testing our data, but monitoring. The number of times I talk to people and say, hey, show me the monitoring of your resources, and I just get a blank look. That's default, right? In Azure, one click, it's there. So I think data professionals, we need to get on board with this. We need to become data platform engineers. It's so easy. There's always a learning curve. But the thing is, like I say, just try it. You know, and you can just go from there. It's really cool. And it will definitely make your job better, because now you can scale out and you can provide value for not only yourself, but for other people by collaborating with those scripts via source control.
Thanks so much for being on the show, Hamish. It's been a pleasure, and I think our viewers have really enjoyed this. Viewers, if you did like this video, please like our video and let us know what you'd like to see next on Data Exposed.